We try harder. This is Distrita.tv, and welcome to our BlackBerry Z10 show today.
Yeah, it's a retro review today.
Yes.
It's a four-year-old phone, right?
Yeah.
And you have just ordered it.
I have it.
Yeah.
And we are going to look at it right now. My name is Michael, and you?
My name is Trond.
Yeah.
It's a pleasure to have you here.
Yeah. And we are the Distrita, part of the Distrita team. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, this is the phone we are talking about.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. This is the BlackBerry Z10.
It's still a good-looking phone.
Yes.
And it's a lightweight phone.
Yes, it is.
Less than 140 gram.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's a 4.4-inch or 4.2-inch.
Yeah. Yeah, that is pretty good.
I think.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it's and the weight is, it's easy. You can try yourself.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you have a case on it as well.
Yeah.
So it doesn't get any bumps or scratches, and
looks
really good. So, and it's a business style phone, so it it works good in meetings and everywhere you are.
Yes. So
and it has a good security.
Yeah, very good security. So I can show you a little bit of the settings. Possibilities here. It has many features for security. For example, you have BlackBerry Assistant, which is like Siri on the iPhone.
Yeah.
For example, and you have also lots of security, storage access, security and privacy is one of the main features of BlackBerry, and it has always that is the feature also on BlackBerry OS 10. Yes.
Yeah, yeah. But since it's a four-year-old phone, can you still find it in stores?
Yes. Well, it depends in which country you are in. I suppose in Asia and so on, it's possible to get it in the stores still. But if you are in Norway, like here, where you are located, it's really hard. So then you have to go onto the internet and search there. And then we can just have a look at Amazon, for example. Here you can get BlackBerry Z10.
Very cheap,
yeah, quite cheap.
Very good price.
Yes,
$45 for a second-hand phone or $80 for a brand new one.
Yes,
that's a good bargain.
Mm-hmm.
Still in 2017.
Yes, and you have lots of features like 4G. You have LTE or 4G or LTE depends on where you are from, and.
Everything you need for a spare phone, at least, if you don't want to have it as your main primary phone.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So it got it got a Bluetooth. It got wireless network. You can VPN get a VPN network on it. So you can use it for even more secure stuff if you don't want to be. Located on the net at all. I can show you some network connections here. There's many features. Also, the phone also features NFC, which allows you to connect it to Sony related hi-fi systems. So it's, for the price, it is pretty great. Yes.
Yeah. But what about the upgrades of the phone? Have there been any recent updates for this one 4 years after it came?
Yes, it came in, it's a bit time since it was released right now. But it was released in April, I suppose. So let's have a look at the features of the phone itself, and what a better way to do it is watch YouTube a little bit. So
Yeah, so you have a nice looking menu.
Yeah. This is some of the features of BlackBerry OS 10. Here it shows how you manage folders on the phone.
Yeah, so you can merge the folders.
Yes. Patrick Maxwell is showing you some of the highlights.
Yeah.
You can delete stuff from your BlackBerry Hub.
Yeah, and I guess that the email software is very good on this phone, right?
Yes. Email, Twitter, or social media, or messages, everything appears in the Hub, so you always have constantly... you know what's happening in the history of the phone all the time.
Yeah, they are known for having a very good messenger as
well. Yeah, so. That is a really, really nice thing. So
yeah, it's really great that they still updated so many years after it was released.
Yes. And also, we can also mention that the phone does support Android apps.
Yeah.
Yes. And there's Android support to some extent. It's not a full implementation. So some apps will work, others won't.
Yeah.
Because,
for example, chat programs like WhatsApp, for example, can you find that to BlackBerry?
Yes, you can. But then you have to go to their own app store, which is a BlackBerry app store, which is you find on the phone, which comes with it. Also, you will find Amazon app store. You will also find Play Store if you install the Google services, yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Yeah. And here he shows you how you can edit pictures or so. The camera features of the phone is really, really advanced for the time it was out. So
exactly.
Yeah, you don't really need to install any additional programs for the basic programs which is installed already. Yeah.
Exactly.
Because they are working as they should. Yes.
Yeah. And you have taken lots of photos with this phone already, right?
Yes, I have. So, you can see them on this Twitter.
Yeah.
And also an upcoming article about the camera of the phone. Because,
that's interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because the price of the phone, the price of the phone is, achievable for most. It's, the phone is from 2013, but you get lots of technology and features that even the latest phones also have got. So you can connect the USB, you can connect the phone to a TV because there's a HDMI connector coming with the phone. So it's really, really interesting for sure.
So this is almost like a Google Now, this feature he now shows.
Yes. So you can talk to the phone.
It's quite impressive.
Yes. Yeah, it's good. So the phone is from 2013. The resolution is 768 by 1280 pixels.
Yeah, that's quite low today, but the inches also 4.2. You don't need too big screen for that size. Yeah.
No, and you don't notice with the human eye. You don't notice the difference that much. You know, and I've seen there's some Android phones this year which have come with the same resolution. So they are cheaper usually, but for the features that you get with this phone, it's good enough.
I guess that you don't need any super processor for this kind of OS as well. Yeah, 2 gigabytes is enough.
Yeah, it's well, it's based on QNX. It's an operating system which is very focused on multitasking.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there's hospitals, there's police and other instances worldwide. I know in America that uses QNX. So to have QNX embedded on phone is a really nice achievement.
So
yes.
The Snapdragon S4 Plus is enough for, for this kind of OS.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
And what about the battery? Can you use it a whole day without charging it? Or?
That depends, because if you run several apps on the phone, I can show you a little bit about it. Because when you can run several apps at once, as you see, and it. If you run more than one app at a time, it will drain the battery faster. So, but it, for me, I can use it the whole day and then have to recharge for my usage. And I use lots of apps on it. So,
yeah. And the surfing experience with the browser and everything is easy and smooth?
Yeah, the browser is actually one of the better features of BlackBerry OS 10. It is really fast. You can browse the latest websites, check the weather, for example. And yeah, there's no... issues regarding it. Yeah, the net is a little bit slow right now, but yeah, there you have it. So the weather forecast for Oslo, 20 degrees and rain tonight.
Wow.
Yeah.
And what about the camera? We have also checked out some other YouTubers, right, about how to compare it with, for example, one of the leaders in the class, iPhone, and one of their older iPhones, right?
Yes. So, yeah. So, we can have a small look at it now. Check. And this is
an 8 megapixel eyesight sensor with a LED flash.
Yes.
1080p video.
Yeah. This tech radar, which is showing you the differences, is quite old. It's from 2013, but
when it came, when the phone came actually. So
yeah. So they've been through London streets and with the camera and taken some photos, showing you the differences between the BlackBerry Z10 camera and iPhone 5.
I find the quality a bit sharper actually than iPhone, according to this video.
Yeah. So,
and even the colors here look better on the BlackBerry.
Yeah. I must say I'm sure it's better on the latest iPhone 7 or the newest iPhone 8, but.
But at still, at this time, iPhone was known for a good camera. So,
yeah. Well, BlackBerry tried, and they should have gotten a better reputation. But
I find the camera on BlackBerry quite impressive when you see the two photos beside each other here. So there is no photo where I can say that iPhone is much better than the BlackBerry, so
yeah,
you get a good value, good bargain for $50 or something like that.
Yes, for sure. It's this is for the price you get it, you get tons of features, you get multitasking, you get security, you get Android support, Google Maps works, I know for sure, Play Store works, and today I installed Gab, which is a Twitter competitor. It also worked, so very cool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So after all, it was worth to order it, right?
Yes. Yes. So it's yeah. I would recommend it to people wanting to try something else. All verdict, total verdict of this phone is that it is better than Yola Sailfish OS, which we can say it can compare to it.
Which is another alternative OS to the two big ones. Yeah.
Sailfish OS was created by Yola, which is a company that was part. Took lots of people from Nokia and made their own company, and they had a huge potential. Also a very fantastic operating system, but it failed. And then now, when I try BlackBerry Z10, I see that BlackBerry has much more stability, and the browser is better. It's almost as good as on the Android. You can use your NetBank, your almost all of the web features works on it. So it's and it's pretty fast too. And you can use a bank ID also.
Which we have in Norway.
So you can use it for transactions and payments. So, that is what the phone got.
And thank you for watching today. Just one reminder before we finish here.
Yes. So
maybe you want to contribute with us.
Yeah. You want to subscribe, but you want to know more. So here is a little bit information about. How to become part of our community.
Everyone has the opportunity to join us and become a blogger, write about your passion, your hobbies, your interests, what you care about. So if you want to be one of the new contributors for the site, just contact us.
Yeah, we want as many to contribute for our website, and let's show you a little video.
Hi everyone, Deshrita.com is your new leading independent website with quality content. Yes, we are looking for you. What is your passion? Your articles or reviews could be about lifestyle, travel, culture, music, concerts, festivals, events, movies, TV shows, gadgets, electronics, trading, affiliate programs, or anything else you love. So, what are you waiting for? We need you as our next contributor for Deshrita. So take action today. Sign up now at contribute.deshrita.com. Welcome to the Deshrita family.
Yeah, that is the site you can go to, contribute.distrita.com. We are sorry for the interruption, but that is we are working with lots of satellites and information coming to our offices. So, but distrita.com, contribute.distrita.com is the website if you want to join our active community, sending us articles and everything you want to contribute with, articles, pictures, and so that is the show for today.
Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day, and over and out.
Yes, have an awesome day.